So you're a homeowner and somebody told you that your pressure tank is waterlogged and you don't really know what that means, or maybe you've got some weird surging of the water and you're trying to figure out what might be going on. Today, I want to talk to you about what is a waterlogged pressure tank, how does it present, and what do you do about it? So let's go ahead and hop into it. Before we get too far into this, I think it's very important to make sure that we set some definitions, right? So first off, pressure tank, what is that? It's gonna be the large blue thing in your basement. Sometimes they're gray, sometimes they're yellow, but 9 out of 10, they're gonna be blue. And the purpose of the pressure tank is to supply pressure to the house. How it works is the top part's gonna have air, bottom part's gonna have water, and there's a bladder in between. Now, old systems may not have that bladder. That's a problem, but we'll deal with that in a minute. So when you have your pressure tank, basically what'll happen is you'll have a switch that turns the well pump on and off. Generally, it'll be a 20-point swing. The pressure switch is the little gray panel underneath of the pressure tank. So when the pump turns on, let's just say it's a 40-60 switch, the pump turns on at 40 PSI, pump, 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 pump. It compresses the air in the pressure tank to 60 PSI, pump turns off. Now, once you use a sink, bathtub, toilet, whatever, that air pressure is then gonna pneumatically push the water into the rest of the house. The expected lifespan for any pressure tank is generally around 7 or 10 years. Now, it's kind of like a water heater. They work until they don't. I've seen these things last 20, 30 years, no problem. I've also seen them only last a few months. It just kind of depends. It's mechanical, right? So some parts are just going to fail because obviously those parts are supposed to move, and sometimes they don't want to move the way they're supposed to and they'll break themselves. So when that pressure tank breaks, generally the part that's going to break is going to be the bladder. There are some times that the pressure tank itself could rot out. Maybe you get a leak. Most commonly, if you're gonna have a leak, it's gonna be right where the T-assembly, which is where that little brass connection or stainless steel connection connects to the pressure tank itself. Right where those two connect, that's usually where you'll see the leak. Every now and again, you might find one on the back of the tank, especially if it's like a really humid basement and it's kind of tucked into a corner, but almost always it's gonna be right on that connection point. So your most common failure is gonna be the bladder. A failed bladder is where we get the term waterlogged. So essentially what'll happen is the bladder will rupture, the water will then get into the top chamber. Usually as a homeowner, it's a little bit harder for you to tell, but how you'll notice is you'll hear a short cycle. Now, most of these manufacturers suggest a 60-second runtime from the first click to the second click. That's gonna be when the pressure switch itself turns on to when the pressure switch turns off. Now, technically, anything under 60 seconds is considered short cycling, and anything over 60 seconds is over cycling. Now, you're probably okay if you're around 30 seconds, but once you start getting below 30 seconds, that's where it starts getting a little bit dicey. Sometimes it can be benign. Maybe they put the wrong size tank in there, but if it's a 10-year-old system and you're getting like 5-6 seconds between first click, second click, the next step is going to be looking at the pressure, the Schrader valve on the top. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna pop off that cap, and we're gonna look real quick what happens when you have a waterlogged pressure tank. So as you just saw, the pressure tank is gonna be full of water. So the moment you click your finger onto that Schrader valve, water spurts out. Sometimes this doesn't actually happen and you can hear the water gushing in there. Now, when this is happening, you're going to also hear the click of the pressure switch, which is going to look like this. So if you hear the pressure switch clicking, just like what we just saw, and you have water coming out of the top of the pressure tank, it's time to get that pressure tank replaced. That's what we refer to as a waterlogged tank. It's game over. You can't fix the bladder inside of the tank. Now, I guess you could, in theory, if you really kind of grinded it open, put a new bladder in, and then welded it shut, but that's a lot of effort, and probably most people don't know how to do that. It's way easier just to slap a new tank in there. So when it comes down to waterlogged tank, you got to replace the tank. There's not much you can really do about it. Another way that you're able to tell if a pressure tank is not working correctly is when you're watching the water run in the house. So let's just say you're doing dishes, taking a shower, or running a sink. What'll happen is you'll see the water increase and then decrease. You're gonna see a surge in the pressure of the water. Oftentimes, you'll see this with a pressure tank that is short cycling or has been waterlogged. Every now and again, though, this can happen with filters being a little bit goofy. So if you don't have filters and this is happening, it's most commonly going to be the pressure tank itself. So let's go ahead and see, what does that look like? The water running like that is usually going to be your first indicator that something's going wrong. And you might be asking, well, who cares? What does that mean if the pressure tank's short cycling or pressure switch is short cycling? The problem comes with this in overworking the pressure well pump itself. So what'll happen is if you don't give enough run time, you're overworking the pump, and then you're going to shorten the lifespan of the pump. So not only will you have to replace the pressure tank, now you'll also have to replace the well pump itself, which can get expensive and tedious at the same time. Now, when you have a loss of water, usually it's going to be the pressure switch or the pump itself that causes that loss. Now, there's a variety of things that can happen, but if you don't do anything about a waterlogged tank, you run the risk of that well pump going up, and then you'll just have no water. And it goes from a, hey, I've got some time to get this fixed, to a, oh no, I got to call somebody right now for an emergency fee to get them to replace my well pump. A waterlogged pressure tank's not super common, but that does happen, right? It's something that can happen very commonly, especially with an older system, older house. And I wanted to make a quick video to show you what's going on, how to identify it as a homeowner, and then, like, what do? Right? So either you know how to replace the tank yourself, or you hire somebody to replace the tank. By doing this, you're going to maintain your system. You'll get better efficiency out of your pump. You'll get better pressure throughout the house. You won't have as many weird surging valves in your home, right? If you turn on a shower, it'll pulsate, kitchen sink pulsate. It'll just feel weird. It'll not function the way it's supposed to function. And then ultimately, if you do nothing, guess what? You lose the well pump, right? So if you found this enjoyable, if you found this interesting or educational in any way, shape, or form, hit that like button, hit subscribe. I have more videos posted every day covering all different varieties of the world of well and septic, home ownership, whatever. If you have an area of conversation you'd like me to talk about, go ahead, leave a comment. Tell me, and I'll try to get to it. I look forward to talking to you guys tomorrow.